Hey guys, up for review is the Xenoplan 17mm prime lens, a Super 16 equivalent of a normal lens, which is a 50mm lens on a full frame camera. Specifications are focal length of 17mm, a largest aperture of f1.7, a smallest aperture of f16, a filter thread diameter of 30.5mm, and a C-mount. First off, the build quality. This lens has a nice and solid build quality that is actually not too much to complain about at all. It's a bit too small to be practical, but its small size is the reason this lens can be so extremely cheap. The lens has the largest aperture of f1.7 and the smallest aperture of f16. It features four aperture blades and the aperture ring turns silky smooth. When stepped down, the four-blade aperture results in a soft square bokeh. However, since this is not uncommon in professional productions, I wouldn't worry too much about that aspect. As all C-mount lenses, this is a manual focus lens. The focus ranges from a minimum focus distance of 30 cm to infinity. The focus ring, just like the aperture ring, is silky smooth. It's just too narrow. The small size of this lens makes its rings very tiny, which makes it a little bit harder to fine-tune settings on the fly. Furthermore, turning the focus ring means that the filter thread is also turning, which is a bummer when using polarizing filters or shooting using anamorphic adapters. As mentioned earlier, the lens has a small front thread diameter of only 30.5mm. Since this is such an unusual size for filters, we recommend using step-up rings to adapt filters with more standardized filter thread diameters. We put together an example of using step-up rings going from 30.5mm to a much larger 77mm, allowing us to use the filter's dimension for other lenses, for example the Canon 24mm f1.4. So the verdict. The pros. The lens covers the Super 16 frame without vignetting. It's really sharp from f2 or f2.8. It's incredibly cheap if you're patient enough on eBay. And it can easily be used on non-C-mount cameras like the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera by using a C-mount to Micro Four Thirds adapter. So the cons. Since this lens is so small, the focus ring is a bit too narrow, which makes it hard to pull focus when filming. This could be solved using a follow focus. Turning the focus ring also turns the filter thread, which messes up any polarizing filter you might be using. This is not a huge problem as filters are easily adjustable, but it does make anamorphic shooting a real pain if the anamorphic adapter is not a single focus solution. Conclusion. This lens is a real bargain and it's actually good enough for professional work. It's sharp enough and with a full focus kit, you'll be in much better hands trying to swing the focus while filming. If you're using a camera with a Super 16-ish sized sensor, this would be a great candidate if you're looking for a well-performing and cheap lens. I found this lens on eBay. Unfortunately for me, my bid of $79 was the only bid in the auction. Right now there are several lenses available on eBay at prices ranging from $99 to $199. This review was graded using Cineluts and was shot on a Digital Bolex D16. Thank you for watching.